Hello everyone, welcome to the Unix session. In this session, we are going to discuss some of the directory and the file related commands like touch command, cat command, cp, mkdir, rm, mv and rmdir commands. So let's see how to use these commands. In order to work with these commands, first we need to understand what is Unix file system and then we can use those commands. So the first thing which we need to keep in mind is that Unix treats each and everything it knows and understands as a file. The next point is that it uses a hierarchical file system and it very much looks like an upside down tree, as you will be seeing in the next slide, that with the root at the top and the directories below it. So you can see this is a Unix file system where we have the root directory at the top and all the subdirectories below it. So what is the reason behind creation of this hierarchical file system is that it helps us to keep all our related files together and we can separate them from other groups of related files. So each directory which you can see is helps to create save all our related files together. So moving ahead with the first one, as you can see, is the /bin. So what does the /bin contain? It contains all our executable files for most of our Unix command. Moving to the next directory, /dev, it is used to save all our device related files. Next is /etc. It is used to save all our binary executable files which is required for system administration. The next is /lib. As you can see from the name, it contains all our library functions related files. Then moving to the next one, /user, also using the name you can find that it contains all our user related files. Moving next is /tmp. Tmp is used to keep all our temporary files together. Then /var is for keeping all our variable data. And then comes your /home. What does the /home do? It is also called as login directory, because whenever the user logs in, this is the first directory that he logs in when he logs into a system. Okay, so this is our Unix file system. So now we have understood that how the Unix file system look like, and then we are going to work in this how to create files and directories and how to work with them. So these are some of the commands which we are going to discuss in this particular session. We'll be working on with the touch command, cat command, cp, mv, rm, mkdir, rmdir, cd and pwd command. So to understand this concept, let's just move to Unix and get started and work with these commands. So we have just logged in into Unix, as we had shown in the first session, where we have to enter a username and password. Then you can click on the new terminal and you get a dollar prompt. So let's just see how to work with the commands. So the first command which we are going to work here is called the touch command. So touch command is a command which is used to create files. So these are used to create an empty file. For example, if I give touch file 1, so touch file 1 creates an empty file. It will contain 0 bytes. So what is the purpose of, if it is creating empty files, what is the purpose of using touch is that using a touch command, you can create many files at the same time. Like if I'm using file 2, again file 3, file 4, so many files I can create at the same time. What is the other use? The other use is that you have already created some files and you want to update its time, then also you can use the touch and the name of that already existing file, so it will update you to the new timings. Okay, so this is how you create your file. There's another command also by which you can create your files, but in that case you can enter the data in the file, because touch is not allowing you to create any data. Now in this file, if I give cat and then the file name, okay, now it is going to prompt me to enter something inside that file. I write where are you and I want to close it, so I'll press Ctrl D. So once you so now okay, we got this content. Now after pressing Ctrl D, we come to the command prompt. Now I want to view the contents of the file, so we'll just give cat and the file name again, file q. So we can view the contents in this file right now. Okay, now we'll use one more, we'll create one more file, cat. Let's say I give file w and then I press enter, and then I'm going to write something. Let's say how are you. Let's press insert. How are you? Okay, now after pressing this, so we have got two files. Now you can see I want to copy the contents from one file to another. We use a command called as cp command. So now we'll write cp and then we'll write file, let's say file w and then file q. Now what will happen, we'll just display the contents again and see what happens. File w. Now you can see file w, so the contents of file w gets copied to file q. So the contents of file w does not change. Now if I say cat file q, you can see it has overwritten. So using cp command, whatever the contents is there, it gets erased and it gets displayed with the new contents. So this is how you can copy. Now we'll use another, wants to remove one file, so we'll use rm command. Rm command is a command to remove the file. Let's say I want to remove one file, so file q. Now if I display cat file q, let's check if the file is deleted or not. So you can see no file or such writing, means the file has been deleted. Okay, now there's another command called as rm minus I and then file. So we'll remove the another file, file w. Now what does this do? So what does the, we have, this is one of the switches which I'm using. Minus I is a switch, so rm and minus I is a switch, and I give the file name. Means I means interactive deleting. Interactive deleting means first it will ask the question. Just to make sure that by mistake I'm not deleting, so we can use minus I. Sometimes by mistake we type a command, so I want to make sure that it is the right file. So we are using minus I, where it's going to ask, do you want to delete? Yes. If you say yes, it's deleted. Now if you just type cat again as file w, you can see that it has been deleted. Okay, so now there's one more command called as minus f, that is for forcefully deleting. Now we need to create one more file in order to use that, cat file. So I'm creating that file again. Okay, good, Ctrl D. Okay, now I want to now use one more switch called as cat minus f, and sorry, not cat, we are going to remove that file. So rm and the switch as minus f and file q. So what it does actually, minus f means forcibly removing the file. So sometimes we don't have the permissions to remove that file, but using minus f, even if we don't have permission, we can forcefully remove that file. Okay, talking about permissions, that I'll be discussing in some of the later session. Now we'll use some other commands called as, now how to create a directory. For creating a directory, we use a command called as mkdir, and you can create one directory, dir1. So Okay, it's already existing, so we'll create another directory mkdir and we'll say dir new. Let's see, it's there. Okay, it's created now. Now if let's see that in which directory presently we are. In order to check, we'll use a command called as pwd, present working directory, to check in which directory we are currently in. So you can see now we are in, as we said, we had just discussed slash home is the first directory in which we log in, and gd so is the and so we are in this directory. Now we want to go to, let's say, dir, so we can do cd and dir new. So it is going to move to, now if I do pwd, now you can see we have moved to dir new directory. Okay, this is cd means change the directory. If I want to go back, I'll press cd space dot dot, so I move to my original directory. If I do pwd again, you can see we are in the, also cd dot dot means just move back to one directory. If you keep on doing cd, it will keep on going back. Okay, now I want to create many directories at the same time, so that also we can do, means not the, like parent and child one. So if you can do rm dir and then space, and then we give dir, and then we give new and slash dir1 slash dir2. Okay, sorry, we wanted to create, so we'll do mkdir, not there's no such directory, and we are making the directory dir new and then slash dir1 slash dir2. One second. So in order to create, you can see that if we give directory mkdir, it doesn't work. So in order to create the subdirectories inside the dir new, what you need to do is we need to use the option called as minus p. So with the option minus p, we can create. Now if we want to check in which directory we are, we can see that we are in a gd. We want to go to, now let's search, we'll just try to go to dir new. So we'll cd and we'll write dir new. Okay, now let's just check pwd. Now you can see we are in dir new. Here I'm going to create one file, cat, and I can use the same file name or different file name, and then here I can write anything, how are you, and then I can press D. I close the session. Okay, now here, so we have filr, this file inside dir new. Now let's just go, just press pwd to check which directory we are presently in. Okay, now I go back to my previous directory, and so now we are in the previous directory using, if you check, we are in gd directory now. Okay, now I want to remove the directory. So now I'll give rmdir and I'm going to use dir and then what is the name? Dir new and slash dir1 slash dir2. So you can see the dir, dir new is not empty, it has a file by the name as filr. So what will this program do now? We want to check that which directory has been deleted. So let's just check with the present working directory. Now we are in this directory. Now we'll just move cd just to check is this directory existing or not. Yes, cd. Okay, now if we do pwd, you can see that we have moved to dir new, means dir new is existing. Now again if we do cd, again if we move to dir1, we'll do pwd present working directory, we have seen it moves to dir1 again. we do cd and dir2 no sir. So it means that when you are using rmdir with the with this, then it deletes only the last directory, which is dir2. It doesn't remove any other one. Now there's one option called as we'll use something called as rmdir, and then we'll use another switch called as -p, and we are going to use the path dir new and / dir1 and enter. So it's failed to remove this dir new because it is not empty. Okay, now so I checked with pwd, we are in directory. Being in that directory, we cannot delete. So what we need to do, we need to go back first. Again, cd dot dot in order to go back to directories. Now pwd, are we in gd? Yes, now we are going to use. So use the arrow key, you can come back to that. So now it shows that only it is not able to remove dir new. With minus p you can delete the subdirectories, but if it is not empty, it is not going to delete. So do, if I want to remove which is not empty, do I have an, if I have a directory which is not empty, I cannot delete it directly. Then there's a command called as rm, and then you use with the switch minus r. And then if you give dir new, even if the directory is not empty, it is going to delete it. But with rmdir, it is not going to delete a directory which is not empty. Now if I do cd dir new, can we see it? No such, it has been deleted. I hope this concept is clear, how to work with some of the commands in the file structure. Okay, so this is what we have discussed. I think we have covered everything: touch, cat, cp, mvrm. See, we covered all of them. So I hope this concept is clear. We'll be discussing more file commands in the next session. Thank you so much for the session.